Yes, of course. This year we have the girls, you know, so it's always exciting to have that, you know, but we reinforce our partnership between ourselves and the federations. We think that in working together, we have the opportunity to develop young people. And of course, when we work with young people, we reinforce the basic value of the game. You know, we reinforce teamwork, sportsmanship, and we think that when young people understand that, they become better players. And it's also a milestone this year, you know, with the participation of Jr.nba Tanzania. Again, it's a milestone globally because this year we have 26 million young people across the world playing Jr.nba, you know, and it's absolutely great to have Tanzania as part of the all Jr.nba family globally. As this season happened, we have a chance to choose if there's a very talented player here to be as part of the African team, which of course we're going throughout Africa to select the best 12 boys and the best 12 girls. More than twice that I've been in Tanzania, all we see in terms of basketball is progress. The structures are becoming more and more solid. Our partnership with the Federation and the seniors here at the JMK Park is really growing. The more we continue to work together, we think players and coaches will understand that the benefit is to have them progress and get better. We want Tanzania to emerge in the region as one of the countries that play basketball at the highest level. And I think we're right on track with that. You know, the development of young people usually take 3 to 4 years. I think now we're on track with that, and we may be able to see a number of players from this group participating in the championship under 18 that the president delivered. All the young players, all the young parents to come and celebrate with us the third year of Jr.nba. You know, continue to participate, the support is important. We have this beautiful park that is here, you know, and with basketball playing here, I think the sky is the limit.